Hello and welcome to season 3 here in Split 4. Season 3. Season 8, round 3 here in China in Split 4. Today I'm alone. I don't have neither Isor or Stelling with me. Stelling is a retired owl, you know. He's watching American Pie at the moment. I can't help it. That and Isor, well, I don't know where he's but he's probably just being smelly down in France. So well, here we have the Shanghai International Circuit, as we can see here. 16 turns, 28 laps, and we're going to go to qualifying comparison. Yeah, there we go. And this time we only have two qualifiers. And we can see here we have Big RT on the left and Scott Gameplays HD on the right in the Caterham. So we can see Big RT is out a bit earlier here. They have very similar lines into corner. Big RT gets it a bit tighter. Looks like Scott actually might be a bit behind at the moment, I think. Yeah. Big RT is actually in front of Scott right now. But the question is if Scott will be able to catch up to him later. And we can see here coming into the next turn, this can't be a 3-1, you can easily go too wide. Looks like Scott have way more speed here. And we see they're actually side by side right now. Down here through the big left-hander. And then slightly either brake or just release throttle a bit and then go right and then brake to go left here once again. It looks like they're very similar pace. I actually think Big RT might be a bit ahead. No, Scott is still ahead. Coming down here to this, well, I wouldn't call it hairpin, but close to. Going around here, as we can see, Scott is also setting fastest lap, and we can see the qualifying is only 6 seconds left, 5 seconds now. Which just means he's approximately, well, almost 5 minutes ahead of Big RT's time at the time it was set. Whatever that's called. I don't know whatever it's called. But we see now the session time have expired, and Scott is on his last lap. Actually going for the pole, as we can also see over in Scott's video, we can see Big RT actually has the pole position at this moment. As we can see, they're still very, very close. It looks like Scott is a bit ahead. Yeah, he definitely is. It's not much, actually. Down here and across the finish line, somewhere around there. Here we see the results. Scott gets the pole position. Krolfau, something from Lord of the Rings, I don't know. And then Big RT in third. Then Initialization is coming in fourth. James, Vinall, Molly G, Yabba Nice Day, Winters, Vin, Kinetic Gupta, Armstrong, Marin, and then Weisgeier. All the way down the back. But not as far behind everyone else as he usually is. So that's actually quite good for him. And here we're gonna go over to the race start. You can see here we have Scott ahead in the big ass, ugly Caterham. Here we can see Big RT, and that's Weisgeier down there in the back. See who's the start gonna be from. It's gonna be from Weisgeier, we can see here, all the way in the back, right behind Armstrong and Mirren, slightly to his right. I think the AMG we can see up to the right is Kinesia Gupta, I think. Excuse me. Yeah, it is. So let's see how this start goes. Weisgeier gets an okay start. Armstrong looked like he had a good one, but he lost it a bit. Now Weisgeier in the middle of everything, going to the corner. Oh, and he gets slammed by the Ferrari. And we can see the Ferrari also going wide down the back. You can see it in his mirror. And that actually cost him positioning. I think he just gained a position over Armstrong, so that's not very good. But he's back on track, still a bit behind everyone, have to catch up now. Seems like he's struggling a bit with the car, actually. Just trying to keep up now and hope for the others to maybe make a mistake so he can go past. Can he go past here on the inside? Oh no, he spins a bit. Oh, and the car went wide there. I think that was Initialization, I think. Oh, and Armstrong comes right in front of Weisgeier. See, he's very unsteady with his steering wheel, so he might be having a problem with the grip. Oh, see, he's taking some weird lines. Might be dirty as well from Armstrong, I don't know. Here, oh, there's someone in the inside, is there? Yeah, it's Yabba Nice Day, so there's two Red Bulls in front of him now, and the Williams of Wynn right behind him. Actually, on the side of him now. Weisgeier is giving plenty of room just to make sure no contact is being made. They're going a bit wide here. Oh, he has something on his outside. I don't think he noticed that. That's Initialization, I think. Yeah, there it is, worse, and he went right by. So that means Weisgeier is now back in 12th place, after actually just gaining a couple of places up in the mayhem up in turn 3, I think it was. That's actually a bit annoying for him now that he finally got a couple of places up. Now going into the second to last corner, having to break. Only trying to avoid. Oh, and he hit.
Sorry,
into the
sorry.
And Yabba was off as well. I wonder why he was. Wonder what happened to Owen. What the hell are Yabba and Initialization doing? I think Yabba was lagging a bit there on both last guys and Initialization screen. Owen, this going sideways. What the hell are they doing? That looked really weird. Oh, here we can see a replay of what happened up to Yava in the front, I think. Oh, we can see who... Oh, it's Molly just flying into everything. I think it was Molly G.
Who slammed
into everyone else and took Yava off. It might have been, I don't know. Here we're back with Vice Guy once again in lap 4 now. We can see someone have been quite off track. Who's that? It's Kaniska Gupta, I think. Yeah, it is. Now, Vice Guy wants to catch up to now. Being a bit ahead of Meron, we can see here 12.9 seconds, almost 13 seconds. That's a good lead, almost a pit stop. And the question is now if Vice Guy have better tires than Kaniska Gupta here. I think they're on the same tires. Oh, and Vice Guy dive bombs. Oh, and he loses his tail. What's he doing? I think he just let Kaniska pass again because that was kind of an unfair move, both dive bombing and cutting the corner. I also think Vice Guy now, he knows he's faster than Kaniska at the moment, so he sees no reason to insist on having the place because he don't know he can get it back any time. You see Vice Guy very close to Kaniska all the time, just up bombing him a bit. Not exactly clean racing, but then again, it wasn't the hardest of contact, so it's just kind of what happens in the race. You see here, Kaniska going wide. Kaniska spins, but apparently almost no contact, and Vice Guy now obviously realizing that he probably was the cause of that, so now he's waiting and see here starting to apply throttle again as Kaniska is coming up to his side on the inside there. Just waiting to go full throttle until Kaniska actually is in front of him, then we see, and then he goes full throttle again, just right in the back of Kaniska once again. And now Vice Guy also gets the DRS because he was behind Kaniska when they came into him. Yeah, the corner of the DRS detection area. So now Vice Guy. Oh, and he locks his rear wheels again. He's done that a lot of times, I think. You can see Vice Guy here still ahead of Kaniska, actually managed to keep the position even though that was a bit of a corner cut. Nicely through this corner, and Kaniska went to pits, I think. Yeah, he did. So Vice Guy is staying out on these tracks, which are pretty worn already now, but I think he's going for long stint, and that's Scott who just got out of the pit, and I think he's on the... Yeah, he took the harder combo. Now Vice Guy is... Oh, he's going a bit wide there, too much speed through, and then Scott gets the place back right again. That's too bad. That was a bold move by Vice Guy, but perhaps a bit too aggressive, I would say. So yeah, well, that's not exactly the way to do it. You see here, Scott is just gaining away from him right at the moment. Then we see Vice Guy here in lap 5 with is that in his last station behind him, I think. Yeah, it is. I don't know what's going on here. In his last station is right up on his tailpipe. Gonna have to DRS here at some point. Vice Guy goes to the left immediately. Oh, and someone is coming up from the pits. That could be interesting. Well, a bit of contact there, nothing really, just slightly race contact. Vice Guy tries to get on the inside, but can't really, he has too much speed to get on the inside. And his legislation is still ahead of him. And the question is now, will his legislation be able to push away, or will Vice Guy be able to keep up with him? I don't know, his legislation might be on new pressure tires, I think. And so, yeah, he's on the harder compound, so he probably already pitted now, which means Vice Guy is on way older tires than him. So he should have more speed on Lister, of course, of gold. Here we can see it's Big RT going to the pits here on lap 6. Nice and easy, no drama there. You can easily crash into that pit lane. It's a very, very stupid pit lane. So let's see what the Force India guys can do. And we'll see who was that coming out. I think it was Lotus coming out as well, making ready for another pit stop. So that could perhaps be Mother G, I think. I don't really know, and I see Armstrong is in the lead at the moment. That might be just be because of him pitting. There we see another car come through, and that's Winters. Oh, that was close. That could easily have been an accident there. And Big RT going a bit wide now, going up to try and catch Winters, obviously. The question is, Winters probably already pitted. He usually pits rather early, I think. So we just see an assassination in the other McLaren, just set the fastest lap time, 1:38 something. We see Big RT here a bit later, still going after Winters, getting closer and closer, now getting some DRS. So it could have looked like Big RT might have made a bit of a fuck up since he was inside within 1 second and now he was this far behind. And we see here very close, it looked like there was some lag bombing there to Winters. I don't know. And now the question is when will he be able to make the move in another DRS zone as well for Big RT? I think McLaren is really struggling. Especially Winters, I think he's going with too much downforce most of the time. Because last season, in season 7, I think the McLarens were probably the fastest on the straight, at least one of them were. And now it seems like they're very slow, especially Winters, so I think he's just going too much with the downforce. But then again, he might think, okay, fair enough, there are two straights, but I don't want the speed there, I want to have speed through all the corners instead. But then again, loads of these corners, as you can see here, are very slow corners where downforce really isn't the thing that matters to you, so... As you can see here, Big RT is getting very close to Winters now, cutting a bit later as well, but he still is close to Winters, having problems getting the final move done, I think. It looks like every time he gets close, it sort of goes wrong for him in some way, and Winters perhaps just suddenly found some speed, and now he's on the inside. Will he be able to make the move done, or will Winters come back on the inside? No. Big RT keeps it wide and simply just closes off Winters, so Winters can't get past. We'll go here, and where's Winters? He's still behind him, right there. So now Winters will probably have the DRS, which could be interesting. Winters going on the inside, knowing that then he will have the best lineup for this corner up here. But the question is, will he carry too much speed through, and will Big RT be able to come on the inside? No, he won't. Winters comes in and closes. He's not big. I don't know that. Winters comes in and closes, so Big RT can get the move done through there. And you can see Scott now up in fifth place as well, but then again, I don't know who pitted and who haven't, so it could be down to anything. And then we're coming here, Winters going a bit wide, having a bit trouble with the car, it looked like. It looked like his wheels were going from side to side all the time. That looked very weird. You can see here, once again, another DRS straight for the sixth time or something, I don't know. Still Big RT trying to get past once again. The problem with this track really is you can often get past here, but then if you aren't quick enough, then you will just lose your position on the straight again. And where's Winters? Winters is behind him now. Winters didn't get good pace out of that corner, I think. Didn't really get the grip he needed. And then Big RT goes right around here again. But now the question is if Winters is too far away somewhere. I don't know that. It's difficult to see. Where is he? Oh, he's very close. He's coming on the inside now. Oh, is he? No. Can he get the move done? No. Big RT comes in close to the curb and simply just closes the corner, so Winters can make a move on the inside. So that's actually very interesting to see here, because, yeah, well, you can easily get up on the inside of some cars if they are on the outside, and suddenly they have to make a room. And here we can see a replayer from Weisskai down in 11, still ahead of Kaneska Gupta, as we can see, going into the pits. You can see very slowly going into the pits, because you can easily fuck it up, and if you fuck it up just the slightest, you can risk you losing your front wing, or perhaps just a part of your front wing, and that will cost you probably more time in the pit stop than if you just take it a bit more slow, so you know. There we can see, I think it was Kaneska got past him out on the... out on the main straight, instead of going into the pits. Of course, he pitted earlier, Weisskai didn't pit until now. Remember to stay and we see Weisskai now coming out of pits, no traffic whatsoever. Now we just have to catch up to Kaneska Gupta once again. I think a bit of time ago I said it might have been Eastern European or something, Russian. I actually think the name is what is it called? Indian, I think. Not Indian like the Indians over from America, but the one over from Asia, you know. Here we can see Weisskai coming close to Kaneska once again, and only three laps later he already caught up to him. And now Weisskai has definitely have the advantage of having way, way, way newer tires, since I think Kaneska hit around lap 4 or something like that. So that means Weisskai tires is around, what, 6 laps new or something like that. Well, ratio would be a better word. Now we can see Weisskai here, oh, and Kaneska. I think that was a bit of a daring move by Weisskai. I think he tried to cut the corner, close it. Even though Kaneska were in there, and that resulted in Weisskai losing some pace here and losing time to Kaneska. And now just have to catch up to him once more again. But like I just said, Weisskai is definitely on Fraser tires, as we can also see. Within this short amount of time, Weisskai is already right up onto Kaneska's tailpipe once again. Now the question is, will he get the move done on this straight? Perhaps he is able to outbreak Kaneska somewhere. Oh yeah, very nice outbreaking. Oh, going into the corner and leaving room for Kaneska. Kaneska is still there somewhere. There he is, and then Weisskai is on the outside and can get plenty of throttle through here. And there Weisskai is just able to get right past him. Now the question is, I actually think Weisskai will get the DRS, because I think he was behind. Yeah, he does. I actually think he weren't prepared for that. I think he's slowly moving to the left to have the perfect line into this corner. Breaking, oh, and losing his tail a bit again, I think. Oh, and Kaneska went a bit wide there. I think he got distracted by Weisskai losing his tail. That's too bad for Kaneska now, that now you have to quite a gap to catch up to once again, and he's going to the pits, which would also just indicate that his tires just were absolutely gone. Here we are with Scott up in 10th, we can see, going to the pit to get new tires, of course. That's usually why you go to the pits. Sometimes it's a new front wing as well, but it's different from time to time. But then now we are with Big RT once again out on track, and he's going to pit as well here on lap 16. She's still very slowly into the pits, don't want to go too fast, otherwise you just end up crashing into everything and destroying your entire car.
Prime tires confirmed for next pit stop.
And it could like look like he's going on the primes now. Is he what has going on? Yeah, it's the primes, definitely the primes. So that looks like it's probably gonna be the last pit stop for Big RT now. Unless of course he plans to just push them like fuck and then take a set off on the option tires at one of the last laps, I don't know. But he should definitely be able to take these tires all the way in, I would say. Then we're going around here again. Oh, who's that? I think it's Winters in front of him. He now has to catch up to like for the 200th time. Yeah, now we can see here a couple of laps later. He actually caught up to Winters now. But the question is, have Winters pitted and when? And or in any case, when will he pit if he haven't already pitted? And also, what tires are you on? Is he going for a 3-stop, a 4-stop, a 2-stop? What is he going for? Which of course is different to know since we don't have any interviews or with anyone, especially Winters. He don't talk much, he's just driving around his car, fooling around, trolling in the back sometimes. Getting killed by other cars. And well, anyways, here we can see, excuse me. We can see Big RT closing in on Winters, having the DRS for the second straight in a row now. So also see here his personal best at the time. So he's just going as fast as he can, just trying to get up to Winters and get past him to get that podium place. I think he really wants it. We can see here right up on his tail, a bit of contact, I think, nothing that really did anything. Then it looks like Big RT might have released the throttle a bit, just in order to not take out Winters or his own throttling for that matter. Because that would have been very bad for both of them, losing third and fourth position to end up in the back if they have either crashed or lost a throttling or something like that. We can see it looks like Winters' tires is older than Big RT's, and I think Big RT is really just... It doesn't look like he really wants to overtake. It looks more like he just staying behind and trying to make Winters make a mistake and make him destroy his tires as fast as possible, simply because he probably knows he might not be able to catch the guy up in second. I don't know who that is at the moment. So I think he's just waiting for Winters to make a mistake somewhere or just simply destroy his tires, and then he can just get the place because Winters needs to go to the pit at some point probably. See here, trying on the inside, but Winters can carry loads more speed through the outside lane. Now we see here going to Ritz, I think it was, and a bit of DRS now. Can he get the move done here? Yep, he's on the outside, going right through. No problems there, just straight through and into the braking zone and braking and going around the corner. Winters trying on the inside, I think. Oh, there might have been a bit of contact, I don't know. At least it looks like Winters now is a bit behind once again. Ooh, going a bit wide there, touching the curb, and Winters is actually quite a bit behind now already. Here's your replay of Vice going to pit at lap 18, I think it is. Yeah, it is at lap 18. And also see he's on the hard tires, and see he's going very slowly into the pits again. Definitely don't want to destroy that front wing. See, the tires is absolutely destroyed as well. You wouldn't be able to do much more on those tires. Going. I think he actually can do this on option, but I think he is making the safe choice of just taking the prime tires, because if he took the option and he ended up in a fight, whatever you call it, somewhere, that could easily end up costing him most of the race if he for some reason destroyed the tires too fast. So now I actually think his goal right now is, you can see there's a long way up to Vin, who's in 10th. And I see Scott going to the pit as well here. At lap 20, that's a lap later. You see now he's already behind Vin now. That would mean now Scott is the last thing to get for Vice Guy. But the question is, of course, Scott doesn't have the big map, so we can't really see where Vice Guy is. But if we were fast enough, you could see it earlier on the last view. He was way, way, way behind. And here, nice pit stop, and here we are with Big RT once again. What's he going to watch here? Oh, he's having the Lotus of Krull right up on his tailpipe. That's the problem with the Force India. You can often have difficulty seeing if there is a car behind you, if they are right behind you, because you can see them in the mirrors. And the white arrows you can see also in Big RT screen here, they are right in the middle of your front, which is white as well, so you can hardly even see them. So if you don't notice anyone up your ass, it can be very difficult to see. Now, Krull just stays behind, don't want to dive bomb into the turn, but it looks like Big RT is going a bit wide there, but can Big RT also gets most speed off the corner and is ahead once again. And at the moment, this actually looks like it might be the battle for the first place, but the question is if anyone will need to pit once again of these two guys. Oh, and there's Kroll going probably with the DRS on the inside. Oh, and he's on the soft tires. He probably just pitted then. Because on the soft tires, you can't go for all those many laps unless you really take care of them, and then you probably can't go as fast as this. As we can see now, he just pulls straight away. No deal there. But then again, he's on fresher tires probably, and he's on the softer tires as well. So that's no deal for him. He's just going straight out of the corner. Now, oh, maybe Big RT can get back at him. I don't know. It could be very interesting if you've got a battle right to the end. Oh no, we don't. Here we are with Scott.
Go on, Vice.
No, that's Vice guy.
Through grid lane back. Do it back.
Vice on the last lap. He's the last car on the track. He just wants to have fun.
Smashes into pieces. The wall.
Obviously just destroying his wing. But like I told, now reversing over the line, I think. But like I also said earlier, he could have taken the option tires.
Oh yeah,
the
that's
now,
stylish.
What they are at the moment.
J turn.
It would have been absolutely suicide, and there he goes across the line. So you can see here the results from the race. We can see Kroll got the first place. We can also see Big RT actually got overtaken by Vin. Well, not Vin, James at some point. Then Winters in fourth, Java in fifth, Mology, Vin in initialization, Scott game place HG, Vice Guy. Then we can see Armstrong and both Kaneska, both of them disconnected from the game. Now Armstrong actually disconnected on one of the last laps, so that's just too bad. And Mirren, he didn't finish. I think his game crashed somehow at some point. I don't remember what happened, but he didn't finish. Here we can see the championship standings now. Here after three races, we can see Crowfire is in the lead with 5 points gap down to Steelbutt, which weren't at this race. And then we see Big RT on the third. There's a big gap there, we can see. Oh yeah, 20 points gap, I was just confused there. We can see a gap of 20 points, then we see James, you have a nice day, Armstrong, the two Red Bulls together, Winters, Mattify and Aslization, Mology, Mirren, Vin, Scott Gameplay, HD, Vice Guy, Kaneski Gupta, and then Yodog, which is last. So yeah, well, that's pretty much it. And yeah, thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time. I get the Bahrain video out as soon as possible, hopefully within a couple of days. But yo, see you guys.